Dear students and friends, I am Musa Kalimullah, assistant teacher in English from Murali Mahamudan Model High School. Welcome to you all. Hoping you are well by the grace of Almighty. Today I am discussing about noun in details. In your previous class, you must have read about possessives. To understand the class clearly, you must know the definition of noun. What is noun, and what are the functions of noun? Let us know. About the definition of noun. Noun is one of the experts of this. It is a naming word. It may be the name of, for example, name of person Rohim, Kareem, Dhaka,
sorry,
doctor, student, and teacher. Name of place Dhaka, house, school, etc. Name of, it may be the name of animals, rat, cow, man. Name of object, table, laptop, computer. Name of action, for example, reading, rowing, swimming, etc. It may be the name of ideas. Education, process, sincerity, sincerity, character, character, etc. Next, let us know about the functions of nouns. There are various functions of noun in English. For example, noun is used as the subject of verb. For example, Mr. Nasir Uddin is a master. Noun is used. Noun is used as the object. Object of verb. For example, Korean, Rohim reads. Rohim reads a book. Rohim reads a book. Noun is used as the object of verb. Then, noun is used also as the object of preposition. Example, Meena is fond of milk. Meena is fond of milk. It is used as the object of preposition. It is also used as the object of compliment. Noun is also used as the object of compliment. For example, they elected him chairman. It is also used as the object of object of compliment, as it is used as the object of compliment of incomplete verb or incomplete subject. It is also used as the case in apposition. For example, Mr. Roy the headmaster of this school is an honest man. The headmaster is the case of noun in apposition. It is used as the case in apposition. Then we have to know the different functions of different kinds of noun. There are different kinds of nouns in English. Generally, noun is of two types. Namely, concrete noun and abstract noun. What is concrete noun? Concrete noun is a noun that can be touched, that can be touched by our fingers, and that can be seen, that and cannot be touched or cannot be experienced by our four senses. For example, table, tree, book, etc. abstract noun. Abstract noun is a noun that cannot be touched or experienced by our four senses. It is visible only. It exists physically. It exists only physically. For example, character. Character, sincerity. Sincerity, honesty. Honesty, etiquette. Etiquette, etc. Again, concrete noun is divided into four groups. They are proper noun, common noun, collective noun, material noun. Proper noun. What is proper noun? Proper noun is the name of particular person, things or idea. Is the general name of particular person, thing or idea of the same kind, such as student, teacher, country, flower, fruits, etc. What is called collective noun? Collective noun is the name of a group or a collection taken together, such as team, party, jury, class, army, audience. Next, material noun. What is called material noun? Material noun is the name of thing or substance that can be measured or weighed but cannot be counted. It's called material noun, such as water, iron, rice, sugar, etc. Now let us know other classification of noun. Noun again may be divided on the basis of calculation. Noun is of two types. That is countable noun and uncountable noun. Now we have to know what is countable noun. Countable noun is a noun that can be counted only. It's such as table, book, house, laptop, Siri, etc.
Next, what is called uncountable noun?
Uncountable noun is a noun that cannot be counted.
It is only measured, measurable.
Such as salt, salt, sugar, sugar, water, diesel, petrol, etc.
Dear students, today I am ending my class. Thank you all. I hope you will watch this class. See you again. Thank you.